Hello students, welcome to Saurabh sir's classes. Today we are going to discuss about West Bengal Police Examination, and in this video you will get to know about the application process, the examination pattern, the syllabus, eligibility, age limit and every detail about this examination. So first let us know what is West Bengal Police Examination. So basically West Bengal Police Recruitment Board, they are inviting applicants for two different posts, and those are constables and sub inspector or lady sub inspector. So these two posts have many vacancies, so applicants can apply for these posts through online or offline, and also clearing all the eligibilities they can apply for the examination. Then after clearing examination they can be employed as a constable or sub inspector or lady sub inspectors. So the applicants interested in giving such examination and interested in such posts should apply for this examination as soon as possible and before the end time limit. So now let us know the application process. How can one apply for this examination? So basically the applicants who are eligible, we will discuss the eligibility criteria also in further this video. But before the application process, once the applicant knows that he or she is eligible for the examination, then he or she can apply online. So we have the institute, or let us say the recruitment board has left the online application forms. So applicants interested can apply through online, or even they can apply through offline also. And in both the conditions, they need to fill up the necessary details about their in the form given. Then they also need to upload their scanned photograph. If they are doing online, then they need to upload their scanned photograph, or if they are going through offline process, then they need to paste their photo on the form. And they also need to submit the documents and the certificates of every detail they are giving in the form. After this, what they need to do is only need to pay the fees, and they will be registered for the examination. And the fees, we will also discuss the fee structure later on. So after this, first let us check the eligibility criteria. So here you can check the eligibility criteria. We have two criteria over here. One is educational qualification, that is how much a student is qualified, and the second one is age limit, that is the age of the candidate. So for the constable post, as I said, we have two posts, two vacancies available. One is for constable, other one is for sub inspector. So for constable, only class 10th pass student can apply, which means that any student who has cleared class 10, who has cleared matriculation examination from any university, whether it is West Bengal, not university, rather say any board, West Bengal board or any other equivalent board. So any student who has completed class 12th, who has passed class, not 12th but 10th, who has passed class 10th can apply for the constable post. Whereas for sub-inspector post, a graduation degree is required. For sub-inspector post, a graduation degree is required from any university, any recognized university. After this, the age limit, as you can see, for constable post, the age limit is between 18 years to 27 years. Any candidate who belong to this age limit can apply for constable post. Whereas for sub-inspector post, the age limit is from 20 years to 27 years. Any applicant who is between this age limit can apply for this examination as soon as possible. So after this, let us know about the selection process. How are candidates selected on the base of their examination? So here you can check applicants to this post will get selected from preliminary written test, physical measurement test, PMT, physical efficiency test, PET, final written examination, interview and medical test. So you can check, this is not a very easy process. You need to go, one needs to go many different types of examinations, whether it is written test or measurement test or physical test or either interview also or any medical examination. So every type of examination needs to be cleared for this post. After this, applicants receive the post after the preliminary examination. If the candidate is selected, he will be invited for the post and for the further examinations. And since the after all these examination, if any candidates is successful in clearing all the examinations, his final selection will be based on the medical examination. final selection will always be made from the medical examinations. So here you can check for constable post. Here we have preliminary written test, then we have PMT, PET, then we have final written test, interview, and then document verification. And for sub-inspector post also we have some more or less something same only, because here also we have preliminary examination, then we have PMT and PET, both the examinations. Then we need to give a competitive examination, whereas here we had final written examination. Here it is named as final combined competitive examination, and after that just a personality test, and you are in employed for sub-inspector post. So after the selection process, let us go through the application fees. It is very important to know the fees you need to pay once you are applying for examination. So here you can check, applicants applying to the post have to pay fees, application fees of rupees 170. This 170 is basically for the constable post, and for sub-inspector post the fees is 270 rupees, 100 rupees extra for sub-inspector post, whereas for constable post only 170. And basically these two, this one and this one, these two is only for general category students. General category students for SC, ST and other categories, they have to pay only rupees 20. Whether it is constable or sub-inspector post, they only need to pay rupees 20. SC or ST only rupees 20. So this was the application fees. Now we have age limit. As I said before, age limit is from 18 to 27 for constable, and for sub-inspector you must be remembering the age limit was from 20 to 27 years. So this is the age limit, and after this age limit we have few relaxations also, but generally not for the general students. The relaxation is only for the SCST or the OBC candidates. And there is a difference. SCST gets a relaxation of 5 years, that is they can be either less or more 5 years, and OBC candidates can have 3 years of relaxation. So this was the age relaxation for the reserved candidates. Now let us know how to apply. So the most important knowledge, how to apply for this examination. So if you are planning to apply for this examination online, then what you need to do is follow these 10 simple steps. So here we have, first you need to go to the official website of West Bengal Police. Then you need to click on the link which says apply online. You will find a link showing apply online. You need to click on that link. After that you need to fill up your personal and educational details. As I said previously, you need to fill up every detail given in the form. After that you need to upload your scanned photograph and signature and the documents also. This is also what I said, you need to upload your photograph in case you are filling the form online, as well as you need to upload all the documents and all the documents containing the details you have filled in the form. After this you need to submit the application form, and you need to take the printout of the application form. This is very important for you to take the printout for any future reference. And after you fill up the application form, you will be given a unique application serial number. Each candidate is given a unique application serial number. So you need to note your application serial number, because this serial number is only allotted to you. And each candidate is allotted another different application serial number, which will be required in future. So you must note down the application serial number. After that, you will be directly sent to the payment portal. After you submit the application form, you will be directed towards the payment portal directly. You need not to do any other step. After submitting the application form, the payment portal page will open. There you need to pay the amount, and once you apply, the system will automatically show how much money you need to apply, how much money you need to pay. And you can pay that through online or through SBI Chalan also. And after you pay the application fee, you will be registered for the entrance examination. So this is a very easy step, but you need to follow each step with care. After this we have the exam pattern. So once you have applied for the examination, all you need to know is the exam pattern, how will be the exam conducted. So the most important thing about the exam is the exam will be totally a MCQ based exam, that is objective type. The languages in the examination should be known as Bengali or Nepali. These two languages, the questions will appear in these two languages. Then we have five subjects. Main five subjects in this examination here is GK, that is general knowledge. Then we have the language, that is grammar. Then we have English, maybe literature or any type of different grammars. Then we have mathematics and reasoning. And each of these five will have 40 questions each. So we have total five different subjects. You can check, we have five subjects and 40 questions each. So the total questions will be 200 in the question paper. There will be total 200 questions in the question paper, and each question will weigh 0.5 marks. Each correct answer will gain you 0.5 marks, and through this, after 200 questions, total marks will be 100. And for this examination, you will be given 1.5 hours. Total time given will be 1.5 hours. You can check 90 minutes. So you need to complete this examination in 1.5 hours. So after this, the most important and the only remaining knowledge about this examination is the syllabus. The syllabus on which the examination will be based. So first of all, let us know the syllabus of English. So you can check, we have many grammatical topics in English syllabus, such as synonym, antonyms. Then we have spellings, tense, subject, idioms and phrases. Then we have parts of speech, common errors. Then we have gender, masculine or feminine. And finally, we have singular or plural. So basically, these are very easy topics and based on class 10 or below. So these subjects basically we have studied in class 10 or below. That is why the eligibility is only matriculation or 10th pass. So after English, we have another subject, or let's say another language, and this language can be selected from Hindi, Bengali, Urdu or Nepali. We have four options and any language can be selected out of these four, and these are the topics you need to cover under the language you have selected. And after that, the only remaining part, the only main topic, is the mathematical section. And this section is the largest and contains the maximum topics as syllabus. So you can check over here, we have many topics and many known topics since our old school days. So here you can check, we have the total syllabus over here. So basically, these three main subjects, that is English, language and mathematicals, cover the syllabus as shown. And the other ones are basic knowledgeable syllabus. So now you know the basic information about the West Bengal Police. So if you are interested in giving the examination, you can apply for the examination as soon as possible.